Good evening, teacher.
Good evening. How are you tonight?
Rain.
Okay, nice.
We don't rain.
Oh, really? Is it raining there?
Yeah.
No.
How are you today?
I'm fine. Thank you. Thank you for asking. And look here, it was raining, but right now it is not. It is not raining anymore. It is not raining anymore. Mm-hmm. Yeah, it stopped. How is everything going?
Fine.
What about your job? Yeah. Monte face.
Yeah.
Okay, good. Nice. Mm-hmm. I see nobody else is in. Maybe because it is Monday.
Yeah.
Oh my God, okay. These guys. Yeah.
Today the class is personal with me.
Yeah. Nice.
Yeah, nice.
You are very special, huh?
Yeah.
Okay, there you are. Let's see, Ana Cristina is connecting, Wendy, Edwin, they're connecting.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
We don't have Monday face.
No, we don't. We don't. We're okay.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Okay. I see these people is connecting. These people are connecting. Let's see. Sometimes we have problems with plural and singular, right? With plural and singular, because usually we don't know if it takes the plural form or the singular form of the verb, right? For example, yeah. With the collective nouns, like people usually takes the plural, right? The plural.
Mm-hmm.
So we say people are instead of people is, right? Pero en español nosotros, gente, lo tratamos esta, in singular. So that's that's why in our brains,
a little confused.
Yes. And it's very common. It's very common that we get confused with that. Mm-hmm.
I feel that I have a little problem with the S and the third person. I forget.
Oh, yeah. Yes.
All the time, I forget that.
Uh-huh.
And second, I remember.
Yes, and you correct it. But yeah. Imagine in Spanish, we have to conjugate the verbs into nine or seven forms. Okay, seven forms. For example, let's say the verb hacer, right? We say, yo hago, tú haces, él hace, nosotros hacemos, vosotros hacéis. So for English speakers, that's very difficult. That is very difficult. Because in English, they only have do, does, do, right? And just that, for plural too.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. And the singular. So I think we have been blessed for our language, right? Our native language, because it's a very difficult language, Spanish. Spanish is very difficult. Yes, it is. Mm-hmm. Hello, Alejandra, welcome.
Hello, teacher. Good morning, good night.
Good evening, how are you? Good
evening, teacher.
Okay, good. Good. Okay, guys, I think we are gonna take the attendance even though we have just some of you here, but we are gonna start with that, okay? Let me get there. Hello, Edwin, we missed you. Hey.
Hello, teacher.
Are you okay?
Yes.
Okay.
Okay.
Okay. Okay, guys, we are going to start with the attendance list. Let me see. Alejandra Vanessa Mora Rodriguez.
Present, teacher.
Okay. Ana Cristina Chavarría Flores.
Present, teacher.
Hello. Ana del Carmen Mejía Álvarez. No, Ana. No, not yet. Astrid Tatiana Jiménez Ramírez. Astrid Tatiana. Not yet. Okay. Vladimir Antonio Santos Valdivieso. Vladimir, are you there? Oh my God. Okay. Carlos Eduardo Maldonado Vázquez. Carlos Eduardo. Not yet. Okay. Giovanni Alexander Ramírez Sánchez.
Present, teacher.
Okay. Jonathan Ernesto Fuentes Marín. Okay, let's say again. Carlos Eduardo Maldonado Vázquez.
Present.
Okay. Juan Carlos Palacios Ramírez. Okay. Karina okay. Karina Noemí Álvarez Mejía.
Present.
Carla Verónica Zuria López.
Present.
Okay. Kevin Antonio Ramírez Sánchez. Luis Roberto Mejía Menéndez. María Elena Romero de Galvez.
Present, teacher.
Nancy Ivette Tobar Rivera. Nancy Ivette. Not yet, okay. Omar Alfredo Mozo Flores. Raquel Judith Vázquez de Córdoba.
Present.
Wendy Xiomara Núñez.
Present, teacher.
Auri Elena Segovia Rugamas. Edwin Eliseo Orellana Vivas.
Present.
Félix Moisés Blanco Araniva. Y Javier Adolfo Mendoza Toa. Okay, guys. How was your weekend? How was your weekend? ¿Cómo estuvo su fin de semana? How was your weekend? Okay. Okay. And what are you doing these days? What are you doing these days? Do you have any activity planned for this week? What are you doing these days? Are you planning going to a wedding? Are you planning going to a party? Are you having a training? Are you having a seminar in your workplaces? What are you doing these days? Are you working on a new project?
Only work.
Only work, usual work. Okay, usual. Everything is as usual, okay? So you don't have nothing new for these days. No? Oh my God, you need fire in your lives, guys. You need to do something, hey guys, come on. Let's see. Uh-huh. Are you planning going out with friends or hanging out with friends? No? No? Yes? Okay. Are you having a birthday celebration?
Only work at the house.
Okay. Okay. Only work. Okay. Well. Well, I tried and I wanted to I don't know, maybe to set a new plan for you. Maybe you could invite us to a party or something like that, guys. Hey, come on. Okay, so let's party tonight, okay? Let's party tonight. If we don't have any plan, then today is the day for party, okay? Yes, there we are. Okay. A ver, con lo que ya llevamos del curso, y ya podemos tener una conversación como de aproximadamente unos 15 minutos, ¿verdad? Más o menos, ¿sí? Con lenguaje básico. Así que vamos a hacer una cosa. Vamos a practicar en este momento una conversación que ya hicimos al principio, solo recordando para cómo decir las daily routines, como trayendo a memoria, ¿verdad? Nos vamos a ir a esa presentación, ¿ok? A ese slide, en donde hacemos la conversación diciendo lo que hacía la secretaria, ¿se acuerdan?
Chat email.
Do you remember?
Write a report.
Ajá, correct.
Write a memorandum.
Ajá. Okay, let me go there and bring and pull out that.
Send an email.
Correct. And it's very nice because we can practice that conversation now that we have more vocabulary, okay? So let's see.
Good evening, teacher.
Good evening. No worries, Ana Cristina. Let's see. Ah, Ana del Carmen. It was Ana del Carmen. I'm sorry. Oh my God. Llegamos al final del curso. Ustedes me van a jalar las orejas, niñas. Ay, no. Okay, voy a sacar ese slide, pero por alguna razón se está tardando en cargar. Estaba en la presentación y me fui hasta las de ahorita porque olvidé ese punto. Ok, aquí está. Here it is. So let me share the screen with you and let's read it, okay? Let's read it. We are gonna do just a little review in this, okay? ¿O lo quieren hacer sin que yo se los lea? Vamos a ver. ¿Dos voluntarios? ¿O lo leemos? Let's read it. Okay, let's read it. Very good. Okay, let's remember that a secretary and a new truck driver are talking here, okay? They are introducing themselves and saying the activities that they have to do. Okay, then in this case, let's start. And it says, hello, I'm Abigail Watson. What's your name? Hi, I'm Ernest Bellevue. Nice to meet you, Abigail. Nice to meet you too, Ernest. I'm sorry, what's your last name again? It's Bellevue. Is it B-E-L-B-U-E? No, it's B-E-L-L-V-I-E-W. Thank you. Are you the new truck driver? Yes, I am. What do you do? I'm the logistics manager's secretary. I schedule the deliveries and send a report by email to the 25 truck drivers. I organize the meetings and trainings. I also call clients every Friday to set the details for the weekly shipment they usually order. I invoice the delivery charge. It depends on the distance. It is about $200. Abigail, when do you send the delivery schedule to the drivers? Well, I send the emails with the delivery schedule every Monday morning. When do you write the delivery report? I don't write the delivery report. The driver writes the report. When does the driver send a report? The driver doesn't send a report. The driver gives me the physical report at the office when he finishes the daily deliveries. Okay, thank you for the information, Abigail. Okay, Ernest, have a nice day. See you tomorrow early in the morning. Okay? ¿Y ahora sí ya recordaron? Okay, let's see. We're gonna say, let's start with Carlos and Maria Elena, okay? Maria Elena is Abigail Watson and Carlos Eduardo is Ernest Bellevue. Okay?
Okay.
Okay. There you are.
Hello, I am Abigail Watson. What's your name?
Hi, I am Ernest Bellevue. Nice to meet you, Abigail.
Nice to meet you too, Ernest. I'm sorry, what's your last name again?
It's Bellevue.
It is B-E-L-B-U-E?
No, it's B-E-L-L-B-I-E-W.
Thank you. Are you the new truck driver?
Yes, I am. What do you do?
I am the logistics manager secretary. I am scheduled the deliveries and send the report by email to the 25 truck drivers. I organize the meeting and training. I also call client every Friday to set the details for the weekly
shipment
they usually order. I invoice the delivery charge. It depends on the distance. It is about $200.
Abigail, when do you send the delivery schedule to the driver?
Well, I send the emails with the delivery schedule every Monday morning.
When do you write the delivery report?
I don't write the delivery report. The driver writes the report.
When does the driver send the report?
The driver doesn't send the report. The driver gives me the physical report at the office when finished the daily deliveries.
Oh, okay. Thank you for your information, Abigail.
Okay, Ernest, have a nice day. See you tomorrow early in the morning.
Okay, nice. Very good. Now, Edwin and Ana Cristina.
Yes, I have it.
Yes, please. Yes, please.
Okay.
Hello. I am Abigail Watson. What's your name?
Hi. I am Ernest Balbino. Nice to meet you, Abigail.
Nice to meet you, Ernesto. Ernest, I am sorry. What's your last name again?
It is Balbino.
Is it B-E-L-B-U-E?
No, it is B E L L B I E W.
Thank you. Are you the new truck driver?
Yes, I am. What do you do?
I am the logistics manager secretary. I schedule the deliveries and send the report by email to 25 truck drivers. I organize the meeting and training. I also call clients every Friday to set the tariffs for the weekly shipment they usually order. I invoice the delivery charge. It depends on distance. It is about 200 dollars,
correct.
Abigail, when do you send the deliveries? Schedule to the drivers?
Well, I send the email with the deliveries scheduled every Monday morning.
When do you write the delivery report?
I don't write the delivery report. The driver writes the report.
When does the driver send the report?
The driver does send the report. The driver gives me physical report at the office. When finished the daily deliveries.
Okay, thank you for the information, Abigail.
Okay, Ernest, have a nice day. See you tomorrow early in the morning.
Very good, guys. Very good. Okay, now, this was in Unit 1 and Unit 2, right? In Unit 3, we studied how to talk about future events, okay? We talked about future events, and also we studied how to talk about things that are temporary in the time, and also the future events were for near future, right? And also the things that we are doing right in the moment that we are speaking. So now we know how to say the daily activities that we do in our workplaces. And also we know how to express the next step that I'm going to do, maybe during the day you are doing something, then you can express that. You can express the next step of that activity. Now you know how to also how to say the date. Now you know how to say the date, because now we can express the future events, right? This unit 4, is to learn how to report a problem. En esta unidad 4, vamos a aprender cómo reportar un problema. Okay, para eso vamos a necesitar mucho el presente simple. Okay, las preguntas. Eso es lo más básico, porque texto por cuando uno le habla, empieza a preguntarle a uno, ¿eh? Y ya hizo esto. ¿Y qué es? ¿Y qué hace? ¿Y qué dice? Léame ahí qué dice el error. ¿Me puede enviar, por favor? Y empieza preguntas. Y uno se queda así, I don't know. Why don't you come and see, right? Because I don't know what's happening. So, tenemos que aprender y reubicarnos en preguntas y respuestas. Okay? So, we're gonna see one very specific expression. Vamos a ver una expresión muy específica para cuando reportamos eso. Ahora, vamos por favor, vamos a ir a ver el objetivo de esta clase y de la unidad, ¿ok? La unidad en sus manuales, si ustedes se fijan, the topic for this unit is tech support, ¿ok? Let me share the screen for you. To start with my slides. Y vamos a comenzar también después de los objetivos con una conversación. Go ahead. Okay. Okay, then, can you define what text support does? What does text support do? ¿Qué hace el soporte técnico, el departamento de soporte técnico?
Help.
Help. Help desk.
Solve problems.
Excellent. Solve problems. What kind of problems? What kind of problems do they solve? Uh-huh. Mm. With computers,
with,
okay, with the network. Okay, network es la red, network. What else? The devices or appliances like printers, okay. What else? With a photocopier, right? So they are in charge of the equipment, technical equipment, that it works correctly, okay? That's their main function. Their main function is that every appliance, every device is working well. Every application, every informatic system, or maybe every internal and external systems, we could say operational, right? Operational thing. That's their main function. Everything is working well. So let's see the objective for this unit. The objective for this unit is that you are going to be able, that you will be able to express common tech support problems. And how to report them by phone. So in this case, how to make that call, right? Now let's see the class objective for today is precisely that, to report a problem via telephone, okay? Via telephone. There are different ways. There are different ways that the company is established for every department can get in contact with tech support. For example, you can send an email, right, requesting assistance, or maybe you can fill a form and take it to the help desk unit, right? So there are different ways. In this case, in this unit, and in this class, we are going to learn how to do it by phone, okay? By phone. So let's see. We did a little feedback already. We are having a conversation time. We will identify some common issues in the workplace, and we are going to identify some solutions to common issues, okay? And we are going to use this phrase. This is a very important phrase. I would like to, okay? And then we are having a written activity to practice this phrase, okay? The grammar of that phrase. So now let's go to the manuals. Everybody to the manuals. And let's go to the page, page 39. Page 39. Do you ever call tech support? ¿Alguna vez ustedes tienen que llamar a soporte técnico? Do you ever call tech support? Yes, I do.
Yes, I do, teacher.
Okay.
Okay.
When do you call tech support? When?
How do you say error?
Error. Error.
Error.
Every system.
Okay, system errors. Mm-hmm.
Okay, system errors.
System error.
Okay. Excuse me? Troubleshooting. Oh yes, that's a very good procedure in these days, because everybody is working from home, everybody is working remote, and you have to know how to control or how to solve your own problems, because there are some problems that is possible for the user of the system, it's possible for them to solve or to resolve those problems, right? So that's troubleshooting, and that's a very important procedure in these days. Es un procedimiento. A ver, ¿quién sabe qué es troubleshooting? Can you tell me what troubleshooting is?
Problem solution.
Okay, problem solutions. Mm-hmm. ¿Alguien más sabe? Troubleshooting. Lo voy a escribir en el chat. Ya lo han de haber visto esta palabra ustedes. Okay. Trouble. Trouble significa problema. Okay, trouble. Y a veces así se le dice a los niños, así bien activos y que solo andan haciendo travesuras. It's a trouble kid. Okay, so eso para que nos dé una idea de que es troubleshooting. Troubleshooting. Do you ever troubleshoot? Do you? ¿Alguna vez ustedes han solucionado su propio problema?
Yes.
Okay. Can you tell me an example of an issue that you can have when you are working on a computer? Can you tell me a problem that you can have when you are working in a computer?
With the printer, okay.
Okay, with the printers, yes, it's very common, huh? It's very common that you have problems that you want to print in color and it doesn't work, yeah. Yeah, you're right. Karina, do you ever troubleshoot?
No.
No? For example, when, okay, I have a problem. For example, I cannot connect to Zoom. Okay, it's not possible for me to get connected. The page that I'm seeing in the screen says loading and it doesn't go from that, okay? It doesn't go over. So what can we do? What can we do?
Wait.
Okay, wait is a very good thing, but imagine. Too much time and suddenly les aparece un pop-up significa que aparece así un mensajito,
una ventana,
ajá, en donde dice ya pasó mucho tiempo para esta acción, mejor reinicie la acción, ¿verdad? O vuelva a intentarlo más tarde, dice, ¿sí o no?
Uh-huh. Yes.
Entonces, what do we have to do? Close it. Y normalmente ya lo sabemos, ¿verdad? Cuando ya se queda mucho tiempo. Ahora últimamente la gente ya no quiere esperar. Dice, ay, reset. Esto ya se está tardando mucho. Viene, yes, you reset the action. And also, finalizar la tarea también, ¿verdad? Nosotros finalizamos la tarea para destrabar el asunto y volver. Eso es troubleshooting, ¿ok? Usted encuentra las soluciones por usted mismo, porque como ya lo ha hecho antes, va aprendiendo que el sistema funciona de esa manera. So it's very important to know that. Mm-hmm.
The keyboard is for other keyboard. Keyboard.
Mine.
Keyboard. Yeah.
Oh yeah.
Right. It's all with other keyboard.
Okay. Yeah. The problem that I had that time because of the letter Z. Yes. I had to connect an extra keyboard. Yeah. An external keyboard because the one of my laptop doesn't work with letter Z. It works in everything else, not in everything else, because Control C and Control D, they don't work. They said, I mean, the technician said that I have to replace it.
Restart the system.
Okay, you see, like, you say resistance.
Restaurar, no sé.
Oh, restore.
Reiniciar.
Okay, reset. Uh-huh, okay. So now let's go to the manual. Let's go to the manuals. And there we have a very short conversation. Okay. Let me go there. This is a very short conversation. Okay, let's see. Peter and Robert, okay. Peter and Robert are talking. So let's see. Good morning, this is Peter from Tech Support. How can I help you? Hi, Peter, this is Robert. I'm calling from the Human Resources Department. I'd like to report a problem with my computer. What is it, Robert? It doesn't seem to work. I see, let me ask you some questions. Okay, this Joan is not Joan, okay? This Joan is not Joan. This is another typo, right, from the manual, but let's see again. Good morning, this is Peter from Tech Support. How can I help you? Hi, Peter, this is Robert. I'm calling from the Human Resources Department. I'd like to report a problem with my computer. What is it, Robert? It doesn't seem to work. I see, let me ask you some questions. Ok, así se los leí como bien lento y sin entonación. Ok, normalmente, ¿cómo son las llamadas a Tech Support? Normalmente.
Hard,
why? ¿Por qué son así como duras y? Ajá, ¿cómo son más o menos las llamadas a Tech Support?
Fast.
Yeah, very quick. You need the things that they have to be done, okay? And usually the people are in a hurry, okay? Entonces están así como en una gran precisión porque tienen que entregar algún reporte, porque tienen que hacer esto, porque ustedes creen que llaman así lento, tranquilo. Ay, me la venía a ver, ahí está la compu. Así llamamos. Ajá, ¿verdad que no? Ok. Ahora imagínense cómo tratar con una persona que está como así muy apurada. ¿Verdad? Muy apurada. Now let's read it in a different way. Ok, let's read it in a different way. Good morning, this is Peter from Tech Support. How can I help you? Hi, Peter, this is Robert. I'm calling from the Human Resources Department. I'd like to report a problem with my computer. What is it, Robert? It doesn't seem to work. I see, let me ask you some questions, okay? Imagínense la persona, ¿verdad? De recursos humanos, okay? Now, I want to hear you guys. I want to hear you, pero sí, okay? Yeah, pero recuerden siempre que debemos mantener lo polite, ¿verdad? Lo polite.
La cordura.
Exacto, aunque estemos enojados. Okay, there we are. Now we want to hear Giovanni and let's see, Alejandra. Giovanni and Alejandra. Read the conversation, please.
Okay. Good morning. This is Peter from Tech Support. How can I help you?
Hi, Peter. This is Robert. I am calling from the Human Resources Department. I'd like to report a problem with my computer.
What is it, Robert?
It doesn't seem to work.
I see. Let me ask you some questions.
Okay. Giovanni está bueno como para Tech Support porque es muy tranquilo él, ¿verdad? Muy así, muy asertivo, ¿verdad? Vamos a ver. Ahora vamos a ver una cosa. Okay. What does it doesn't seem to work mean? ¿Qué significa esta frase? It doesn't seem to work.
Ajá. No trabaja, no veo que trabaja.
Ok, ajá.
No funciona.
Ok,
no
funciona. That's better. Ajá. Ajá. But it doesn't seem, es como que dijéramos no se ve que. Ok, no se ve que. Y to work in this case es funciona. Ok, trabaja, pero sería funciona. Okay, so no se ve que esté trabajando, ¿verdad? No se ve que trabaje esta cosa. Okay, it doesn't seem to work. It doesn't seem to work. Okay, vamos a ver todos. Vamos a leer todos la conversación y luego nos vamos a ir a practicarla. Pero, bueno, hagamos estas dos cosas primero y luego les explico otra cosa. Okay. Good morning, everybody, please. Good morning.
Good morning.
Good morning.
This is Peter from Tech Support.
This is Peter from Tech Support.
How can I help you?
How can I help you?
Hi, Peter.
Hi, Peter.
This is Robert.
This is Robert.
I am calling from the Human Resources Department. I'd like to report a problem with my computer. What is it, Robert? It doesn't seem to work.
It doesn't seem to work.
I see. Let me ask you some questions.
Let me ask you some questions.
Okay. Vamos a separarnos en las salas para que puedan practicar la conversación. Pero vamos a sustituir los nombres y el departamento al que ustedes pertenecen, ¿ok? The department where you work at, ¿ok? So, for example, if you work in accounting, then you have to say, I'm going to say Ana Cristina from accounting department, ¿ok? I am, and you say your name and the department that you belong to. Okay? Esa es la primera cosa. The second thing, la segunda cosa, is that we are going to discuss these two questions. Okay? What is the issue with Robert's computer? And what does the how does he report the problem? How does he report the problem? Okay? ¿Alguna pregunta con la actividad que vamos a hacer?
Repeat, please.
Okay, we are going to practice the conversation. One thing. Second thing is that you have to substitute or you have to play a real role, okay? Ustedes van a sustituir su nombre y su lugar de trabajo o su departamento en que trabajan, okay? And then, third thing is to answer the two questions below the conversation. Van a contestar las dos preguntas abajo de la conversación. Okay. Questions?
Teacher, ¿puede poner la imagen de regreso para tomar la captura?
Ok.
Por favor.
¿Y si se las envío? Creo que me va a ser más fácil. Vamos a ver. Les voy a... Bueno, voy a hacer los grupos. I'm going to split you into the rooms. Split up. One thing. Y luego inmediatamente yo se los envío. Let's see.
Teacher,
yes,
question.
Tell me.
Department, for example, sería en vez de human resource, mm-hmm. el department al que yo pertenezco, ¿verdad?
Exactly.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Mm-hmm. Gracias.
Okay.
Aquí en donde dice Robert.
Okay.
Okay. Empiece usted y yo sigo.
Okay. Good morning. This is good morning. This is Alejandra. Sí, ¿verdad?
Yes.
Okay, good morning. This is Alejandra from the support. How can I help you?
Hi, Alejandra. This is Raquel.
I am calling from the Human Resource Department. I'd like to report a problem with my computer.
What is Raquel?
It doesn't seem to work.
I see. Let me ask you some question. Sí, ¿verdad?
Let me ask you some question.
Okay.
Y aquí en la uno es donde iba a decir usted dónde era o en la.
Quiero ver, what is the use? ¿Cómo se pronuncia esa palabra? What is the.
Hello, girl. Here I am.
Teacher, es el number one.
Ajá.
What is the. ¿Cómo se pronuncia esa palabra?
Issue.
Mm-hmm. Bueno, ya creo que significa.
En la primera pregunta, dice usted.
Sí.
Oh, yes, issue. Pero yes. Acuérdense que por ahí tienen a Carlos. Carlos entró despuesito porque tenemos una situación con Juan Carlos, entonces no puede ingresar ahorita a la práctica. Está un poquito mal de salud. Entonces tenemos aquí a Carlos, así que porfa, practiquen con él la conversación también, ¿ok?
Ok.
Entonces, practicamos con Carlos.
Ok, Alejandra podría comenzar la conversación y Carlos, con, o sea, Alejandra y Carlos y después Raquel y Carlos, ¿right?
Ok.
Ok, teacher.
Ok, go ahead.
Good morning. This is Alejandra from the support. How can I help you?
Hi, Alejandra. This is Robert. This is Carlos. I am calling from the Human Resource Department. I'd like to report a problem with my computer.
What it is, Carlos?
What is it? Say, what is
what,
it?
What is it, it, Carlos?
It doesn't seem to work.
It doesn't seem to work.
I see. Let me ask you some question.
Let me ask you some question. Okay, now Raquel and Carlos, you can.
Comienzo yo, Raquel.
Okay, está bien, Carlos. Juan Carlos.
Okay. Raquel sería. Okay. Good morning. This is Carlos from the test support. How can I help you?
Hi, Carlos. This is Raquel. I am calling from the Human Resource Department. I'd like to report a problem with my computer.
What is it, Raquel?
What is it, Raquel?
It doesn't seem to work.
I see. Let me ask you some questions.
Okay, good. Now you can discuss the two questions that you have below, okay? I'm going to another room. So continue, guys.
What is the use?
El folleto usted ahí.
Sí.
Porque aquí abajo hay otro.
Pero ahí solo dice which problems are the most common reasons to call tech support. Pero yo creo que solo esto porque dice pay work. Solo esa pregunta.
Entonces solo estos dos contestaríamos.
Hello, how are you guys?
Hello, teacher.
Okay. How are you feeling today, Vladimir? What about your back? ¿Ya se siente mejor? Do you feel better?
So.
Okay. ¿Y está con incapacidad?
Es que estaba de vacaciones. Bueno, incluso todavía tengo unos días de vacaciones. Esa fue la mala suerte.
Híjole, okay.
No puedo pedir.
Ajá. Okay, ¿qué vacación? ¿La pasó en cama?
Sí, los últimos días prácticamente.
Okay. Did you practice the conversation?
Yeah.
Okay. Did you switch roles? ¿Cambiaron papeles?
Yes.
¿Sí? Okay. Yes. Did you answer the questions?
Yes.
Okay. Okay, then that's the activity for now, okay? I'm going to another room. Continue practicing the conversation. Enfóquense en cómo contestar el teléfono. ¿Ven ustedes la primera forma de cómo se contesta el teléfono y la pregunta que se hace, ¿verdad? How can I help you? Okay?
Okay.
There you are. Okay, see you.
Hello.
Hello, how can I help you?
Hello. Me salí del grupo, ¿o cómo?
No, ya nos llamaron.
No, it's okay. You are in the main room.
Okay, teacher, okay.
Very good.
Okay.
Let's focus.
Teacher, good evening.
Good evening, Omar. I see that you are still working.
Okay, I am taking a break.
Oh, okay.
Okay, teacher, más o menos no le entendí muy bien la práctica de la conversación, yes, pero la parte de las como preguntas, mi question.
Okay. Solo son dos preguntas, ¿ok? Las que tenían que discutir con su compañero. Solo eran dos preguntas and they were based on the conversation. Estaban basadas en la conversación. ¿Ok?
Okay.
Mm-hmm. Chicos, ahorita voy a tomar la asistencia. I'm going to take the attendance and then we are going to talk about the activity, ¿ok? Alejandra Vanessa Mora Rodríguez.
Present, teacher.
Okay. Ana Cristina Chavarría Flores. Ana del Carmen Mejía Álvarez.
Present, teacher. Present, teacher.
Astrid Tatiana Jiménez Ramírez.
Present, teacher.
Okay. Vladimir Antonio Santos Valdivieso.
Present, teacher.
Carlos Eduardo Maldonado Vázquez.
Present.
Giovanni Alexander Ramírez Sánchez.
Present, teacher.
Jonathan Ernesto Fuentes Marín. Juan Carlos Palacios Ramírez. Karina Noemí Álvarez Mejía.
Present.
Carla Verónica Zuria López. Carla, are you there? Okay. Kevin Antonio Ramírez Sánchez.
Present.
María Elena Romero de Galvez.
Present, teacher.
Nancy Betova Rivera.
Present, teacher.
Okay. Omar Alfredo Mozo Flores.
Present, teacher.
Raquel Judith Vázquez de Córdoba.
Present.
Wendy Xiomara Núñez.
Present.
Auri Elena Segovia Rugamas. Edwin Eliseo Orellana Vivas.
Present.
Ok, luego tenemos a Félix y Javier. Right. Ok, there you are. Ok, now let's focus on the way to answer the phone. Ok, ¿cuál es la forma en que nosotros contestamos el teléfono de una manera que ofrecemos nuestro servicio? So let's see the question that we have in the conversation. We say our name and then a question. What is the question?
How can I help you?
Correct. How can I help you? Mm-hmm. How can I help you? Ahora, vamos a ver. Ustedes con su nombre van a responder el teléfono, okay? Now, let's see. Edwin.
Hello, how can I help you?
Good. Hey, clap everyone. Very good, very good. So, if you see, lo único que le faltó fue decir su nombre, pero porque lo agarré así. Right. Ahora, vamos a decir primero, voy a decir a quién. Hello. Okay, voy a decir quién va a contestar. Y después solo va a sonar, y entonces contesta, ¿ok? ¿Cómo contestarían? Hello. Ajá. ¿Cómo dice la conversación? Todos la conversación. ¿Cómo dice la conversación?
Good morning.
Ok,
this
pero
is como, morning. This is Peter.
Como no estamos en morning, ¿verdad? Podríamos utilizar un buen saludo.
Good evening.
Hello. Excellent.
Good. So now let's see. Aha, let's start with Kevin.
Good evening. He is Kevin. How can I help you?
Good. Now let's see. Nancy. Good
night. This is Nancy from Tech Support. How can I help you?
Excellent. So let's see. You said good night. It's better if we say good evening to say hello, right? Cuando decimos de entrada es good evening. Cuando decimos despedida es good night, okay? De entrada es good evening. Entonces, contesto el teléfono. De entrada, para decir hola en una reunión que es de noche, mm-hmm. no decimos good night, decimos good evening. Good evening.
Good evening.
Ajá. Es como decir hola. Pero si ya me voy de la reunión o me voy de la conversación, finalizo, entonces digo, ok, good night. Ese sería como el adiós, ¿ok?
O me voy a dormir.
Yeah, that's the real meaning. Okay, let's see. Now, let's see. Carlos Eduardo.
Good evening. This is Carlos from the support. How can I help you?
Very good. Very good. Ahora, antes de que sigamos, todos, digamos la pregunta. Let's say the question. How can I help you? Everybody. How can I help you?
How can I help you?
How can I help you?
I help you.
How can I help you?
How can I help you?
Okay. Les voy a dar ahorita unos 20 segundos para que lo repitan y lo repitan. Ustedes solitos ahí. How can I help you? How can I help you? How can I help you? Everybody. How can I help you? How can I help
how
you?
Can I help you?
How can I help you? Okay. Aquí tienen how que cerrar. Eso.
How can I help you?
Correct. Tienen que cerrar. Acuérdense que no es hell, es help. Hell es otra palabra feita, ¿verdad? Entonces, help, help. Tenemos que cerrar la P. At the end, help you, help you. Okay.
How can I help you? Help you.
Yes, yes. Okay. Now, let's see. Cuando vamos a decir nuestro nombre, cuando vamos a contestar, normalmente. Ok, esto es no, porque sí podemos decir my name is Carmen, my name is Roberto, my name is, podemos usar esa frase, my name is, pero lo usual, the usual, es que digamos this is, ok, this is Carmen, ok, this is Carmen, cuando contesto, for example, I say good evening, this is Carmen, how can I help you, this is Carmen, how can I help you, ok. Good evening, this is Carmen. How can I help you? Okay. Otra manera es que digamos el lugar de donde estamos contestando o la compañía o el departamento, ¿verdad? En este caso estamos hablando de tech support. Entonces tendríamos que decir, this is Carmen from tech support. How can I help you? Okay. Good evening. This is Carmen from Tech Support. How can I help you? A ver, todos hagan su speech ahí, su saludito. Ok. Su saludito. Okay. Are you ready now? Okay, let's see. María Elena.
Good evening. This is María from Colgate Panoramive Support. Can I help you?
Very good. Nice, María Elena. Very good. Okay, now let's see. Ana del Carmen.
Good evening. This is Annie from the Inversiones Airport. How can I help you?
Very good. Now let's see, Omar.
He says he's not here.
Okay.
Okay, perdón, teacher. Sorry.
Okay, no problem.
Okay, good evening. This is Omar. How can I help you?
Okay, very good. Now let's see. Thank you very much. Now let's see. Edwin.
Hello. Good evening. This is Edwin from the Human Resource Department. How can I help you?
Very good. Karina.
Good evening. This is Karina from Tech Support. How can I help you?
Very good. Astrid.
Good evening. This is Astrid. How can I help you?
Okay, very good. Alejandra.
Good evening. This is Alejandra. How can I help you?
Very good. Now let's see. Giovanni.
Good evening. This is Giovanni from Credit Solution. How can I help you?
Okay, very good. Now let's see, Nancy. Tilililililililili.
Hello, good evening. This is Nancy from Consumer Support Acofran. How can I help you?
Very good. Wendy. Tilililililili.
Good evening. This is Wendy. How can I help you?
Okay, very good. Let's see. Who's missing here? Ana Cristina.
Good evening. This is Cristina from BLP. How can I help you?
Very good. Now let's see. Jonathan.
Good evening. This is Jonathan from Cotecna. How can I help you?
Okay. Carlos Eduardo.
Good evening. This is Carlos from Tech Support. How can I help you?
Very good. Vladimir. Okay.
Good evening. It is Vladimir from Tech Cotecna. Won't I come help you?
Very good. Do you see who's missing? Who's missing? Kevin. Again, Kevin.
Sorry. There we go. Good evening. This is Kevin. How can I help you?
Okay, very good. So this is the way to answer the phone, okay? Offering our help with something, okay? Usually in our jobs is for, the calls are for someone asking for something, okay? So this is the way to offer our help. Karina, Astrid, Alejandra, Giovanni, le dijimos a Giovanni en esta segunda vez. No, ¿verdad, Giovanni?
Yes.
Oh, okay. ¿Quién me faltó? Okay, Omar, sí, todos estamos, okay. Bueno, eso es con el saludo. That's the way to answer the phone. Ahora vamos a la parte que nos corresponde en esta clase. En esta clase nos corresponde como también responder a ese saludo, a ese primer saludo, ¿verdad? Porque nosotros marcamos la extensión de Tech Support, nos contestan de esa manera, o nosotros contestamos, ¿verdad? Así, pero ¿qué sigue después de eso? Vamos a ver. What's the next part? What is the next part? Okay, nos tenemos que presentar. We have to say our names and the reason. Why are you calling? Okay, why are you calling? Entonces utilizamos, si se fijan, el presente progresivo, el presente continuo, ¿verdad? I am calling, I am calling. Entonces empezamos así, for example, right? Decimos nuestro nombre. Podríamos decir también good morning, ¿verdad? Para hacer así como siempre siguiendo la cortesía. Podemos contestar hi dependiendo de cuánta confianza o la manera, ¿verdad? En que nos llevamos con los compañeros de trabajo. Usualmente, usually tech support are people that maybe we don't know or we don't have relation every day, okay? So maybe we see that people, but we don't, those people, but we don't have a relationship with them, probably, okay? Pero sí podemos contestar así, hi, okay? Podemos decir hello, good morning, good evening, o dependiendo el saludo correspondiente a la hora en que estamos, good afternoon, okay? Then we say our names. We say our names. Usualmente con nuestro nombre ya saben de por dónde, de dónde estamos llamando. Because they know the areas and the departments. Okay, so let's say hi. Okay, hi. ¿Y cómo vamos a decir nuestro nombre? De la misma manera que se presentó el anterior. This is Carmen. This is Ana Cristina. This is Wendy. Y luego la razón por la que estamos llamando. I'm calling. Y nos presentamos del lugar de donde le estamos llamando para que se ubiquen más o menos, ¿verdad? Porque a veces por el sistema pueden entrar, ¿verdad? Y decir, ah, bueno, lo tienen como desglosado, ¿verdad? De los departamentos y las aplicaciones que se usan en cada departamento. Entonces, I'm calling from the Human Resources Department. I am calling from the Accounting Department. I'm calling from Marketing Department. I'm calling from Customer Service Department. I'm calling from Sales Department. I am calling from the headquarters. I am calling from the, let's say, tell me another department, guys. What departments are in the company? ¿Qué departamentos podrían ser?
Transport department.
Okay, very good. Transport. Mm-hmm. What other?
Production.
Production, good. Uh-huh.
Teacher, how do you say control de calidad?
Quality control. Quality control.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Accounting.
Yes. Mm-hmm. Okay.
Operation.
Good, uh-huh. Operation manager, okay. Mm-hmm. Or the operation managing.
Financial department.
Correct, the financial department, okay. So if you see, we have a lot of departments in a company. In this case, we are going to say the department where we belong to. Okay. Y utilizamos esa frasecita. I'd like to. I'd like to. Okay, I'd like to, I'd like to. ¿Han escuchado esa frase antes? That phrase is coming from this other phrase, I would like to. Okay, que en realidad esto es una forma de decirlo con cortesía, that I want, okay, I want. I want es como bien directo, ¿ok? I would like to es como más con cortesía, como más suavizado el asunto y más polite, ¿ok? More polite. When we say I'd like to, we are saying I want. But it's better to say I'd like to. En un área profesional es mejor decir I'd like to, ¿ok?
¿Y cómo, y qué significa entonces?
Significa I want.
No, en Spanish.
Yo quiero, I want.
Ah, yo quiero, okay.
La
sí,
contracción.
Like me gustaría.
Pero como va acompañado de would, okay. Y, y lleva to, ¿verdad? I would like to. Es completa la frase. Complete.
Por Boulevard que ya nos vamos del Venezuela. ¿Verdad?
I'd like to. Hey, come on.
Yes, yes, yes.
No, we're not going.
Sorry, sorry, sorry.
Okay. There you are. Okay, guys. Let's see. Oh. Okay, here we are. I want or I... La contracción que vemos acá es I'd like to report. I'd like. ¿De dónde viene eso? De I would like to. Y se contracta de esta manera. I'd like to. Okay. Esa es la forma de contractarlo en la manera afirmativa. Okay. I'd like to. Y significa I want, pero de una manera más amable. Okay. De una manera más amable. Sorry, guys. Sorry, guys. Okay, pero de una manera más amable, ¿verdad? Tengamos cuidado ahí con el audio, chicos, porque estamos en la clase y pues le molesta, nos molesta a los que tenemos los audífonos, esos sonidos fuertes, por favor. Ok. Vamos a ver. Ahora. Esto es en primera persona y exactamente es lo mismo para la tercera persona. Podríamos decir, she would like to. O podríamos decir, he would like to. ¿Ok? Y no hay variación. ¿Ok? No hay variación. Cuando pronunciamos completo, would no pronunciamos esta letra L, ¿ok? We don't pronounce this letter L. We say would, would, ¿ok? Would, ajá. Then, lo mismo para los plurales. We, ¿ok? Lo mismo para they, ¿ok? Entonces, en todo caso, sería ella quiere, ¿verdad? Él quiere, ¿sí? Nosotros queremos, so I would like to, you would like to, pero ahorita en la conversación, como quien está expresando el problema, somos nosotros y eso es lo que más nos interesa, ¿verdad? A menos que usted vaya a hablar en una tercera persona, digamos que lo manden a usted a hacer una llamada, y usted tiene que decir she, okay, or he. Por eso lo menciono, okay? Porque pueden utilizarlo de la misma manera. You can use it at the, in the same way. Then, the contractions are the same. The contractions are the same. So, she'd, I'm sorry. Here we are. Mm-hmm. Okay, like this. This is the contraction. He, the same. Okay, he hit. Okay. And for day is the same. You see? There you are. Okay. Esta frase, como es muy polite, es muy amable, es muy de cortesía, ¿verdad? La van a encontrar ustedes, si ustedes se ponen a buscarlo, porque yo sé que ustedes investigan, lo van a encontrar relacionado con ordenando en un restaurante, eso se utiliza mucho en esos lugares. When you go to a restaurant and you want to order something to eat, food, then you use this form. Y esta frase, como es muy polite, la utilizamos cuando hablamos por teléfono, okay? So when we make a call and we are talking by phone, then we use I'd like to. I'd like to. Quiero, okay? I'd like to. So let's go and see this. This is Carmen. I'm calling from the Human Resources Department. I'd like to report a problem. I'd like to report a problem with my computer. Okay, with my computer. Now, después de eso viene una frase muy bonita. What is it? What is it? ¿Qué significa en realidad? What is the problem? Okay. So if we say, what is it? Okay. We are asking, what is the problem? Okay. Pero lo podemos decir así bien abreviado, right? What is it? Y esta es una pregunta que, por ejemplo, utilizamos con los niños, las mamás o los papás, ¿verdad? Llega el niño, mamá, right? And they say, moms always say, what is it, baby? What is it? What is it? So it's the same as asking for what is the problem, okay? What is the problem? So this is the way to obtain an answer, okay? What is the problem? Or what is it, Robert? What is it, Robert? Como que le estuviera preguntando, what happened, right? Okay. What happened? Esa frase la tenemos más común, ¿verdad? What happened? Pero es bueno también, what is it? What is the problem? Okay. So let's continue. This phrase is very common and we say, it doesn't seem to work. It doesn't seem to work. Se ve como que no funciona. It doesn't seem to work. Okay. Do you have any question about the vocabulary until so far? Hasta ahorita, alguna pregunta?
Teacher.
Tell me.
I'd like to report a problem.
Yes.
Es in Spanish.
Yes, say it.
al parecer o tengo un problema con el reporte. ¿O cómo se traduce?
No. Quiero reportar un problema.
Ok. Uh-huh.
Sería, teacher, yo quiero reportar un problema o quiero reportar un problema.
Correct. Mm-hmm. Okay. Are we okay with this? Now it's your turn because you were working in this, so let's discuss the questions. Let's discuss the questions. What is the issue with Robert's computer? What is the issue with Robert's computer?
It doesn't seem to work.
It doesn't seem to work.
It doesn't seem to work.
Mm-hmm. Ok, pero esa frase dice algo. Si a usted le hablan, ustedes hablan a Tech Support y le dicen, ¿qué es lo que sucede? Mira, esto parece que no funciona. So, what is the problem? Right?
My computer.
Ajá. We need to be specific, right? We need to be more specific when we report a problem. We need to explain what seems to be the problem, okay? What seems to be the problem? So I can say, it doesn't seem to work. Yeah, maybe it doesn't turn on, it doesn't turn off. Or maybe the screen's frozen, or it doesn't load any program. What is the problem? Okay.
Paper is stuck in printer.
Ah, okay. Then below we have some other issues, right? We have some other issues. A ver, tratemos de pensar. Let's try to think about issues. ¿Qué problemas podríamos tener con una computadora? What problems could we have with computers? What problems? What issues?
Don't start.
Okay, it doesn't start. Uh-huh. Mm-hmm. What other problem or what other issue? Mm-hmm. Uh-huh.
The screen is frozen.
Okay, very good. Uh-huh.
Network.
Okay, uh-huh.
Internet is slow.
Okay, good. Uh-huh.
Delete file.
Deleted, yes.
Virus.
Okay. Viruses. That's a very big problem too. Yeah, viruses. Mm-hmm.
Attachment don't open.
Okay, good. Mm-hmm.
It doesn't save the files.
Good. Uh-huh. It doesn't save the files. Uh-huh.
No. Maybe connect to the server.
Okay, good. It doesn't connect to the server. Mm-hmm. Okay. The death screen, right? The blue screen. Oh,
a blue screen.
Yeah. That's when you, yeah. Oh, what did I do?
Digital screen. Death screen.
Death. Uh-huh. Death screen. Yeah. Usually we get scared with that, right? Maybe.
Yeah, and stranger noise.
Strange noises. Uh-huh. Noises. Podría ser, si es plural, strange noises. Si es un sonido, strange noise. Pero usamos una frase, utilizamos una palabra como un sonido desconocido y raro, ¿verdad? Sería funny noises. Funny noises. Desconocido y extraño. Mm-hmm. Funny noises. We don't know what happened and it sounds from here or from here. I don't know where it is sounding, but this is sounding. So it has a noise. It's making noise. So we say funny noises. Now let's go to our manuals, and there we have a list. Uh-oh. Okay, there we have a list. Esto es porque nosotros tenemos que ser como más específicos, right? More specific when we talk about or when we express the issue, okay? When we express the issue. Pero la forma de cómo reportarlo, okay? The way to report this. Solo terminemos con la pregunta número dos, with question number two. Let's see the question. It says, can you read the question, please, Wendy?
How does he report the problem?
Okay. What will be a good answer for that? Ana Cristina.
She is calling.
Uh-huh.
She's calling.
Okay, then. Okay, by phone, then. Right?
By phone. Right?
By phone.
Okay, by phone.
Very good. He's calling. Okay, now let's continue and see this. Let's read the A instructions, please, Karina.
Check which problems are the most common reasons to call tech support.
Okay, let's see the problems that we have on the list, okay? And then we check which of those are more common. Vamos a leer la lista primero, and then we are going to mark. Okay, después vamos a marcar cuáles son como los más comunes, right? New software. No internet access. No internet access. A virus. Deleted files. Papers stuck on printer. Papers stuck in printer. USB ports out of order. USB ports out of order. Funny noise in the CPU. Frozen screen. Now, let's see. Let's look at this. What do you think, Kevin, it will be the most common reason to call tech support? ¿Cuál sería como la más común?
No internet access.
Ay, virus.
Fan noise in the CPU.
In the CPU, uh-huh. Okay, so Is everybody agree? I mean, does everybody agree with this? What do you think?
Yeah. New software.
For the new software. When they, I mean, when...
Frozen screen.
Frozen screen. Oh, okay. Uh-huh. Well, it could be one. Uh-huh.
IBRS.
Which one?
A virus.
Okay. Well, do you think is that common in our jobs? ¿Ustedes creen que eso es como común en nuestro trabajo?
No. It's dangerous.
Yeah, but do you think that it is common? It is not, right? Porque tienen...
No, antivirus.
Usually, yes. Usually, the companies have the firewalls, okay, or the antivirus virus systems or applications, right? Programs, or they develop the firewalls, right? They develop that.
Policies.
Policies.
And proxies.
Oh, okay. But in that case, for example, if they get a virus, do you think it will be a problem in a big company? What do you think? A virus in a big company. It's not usual, right? It's not usual.
Rarely.
Rarely, uh-huh. It rarely happens. Okay. Then, no internet access. That's the most common, right? I think so too, Kevin. What do you think, Karina?
No internet access. Mm-hmm. Paper stuck in printer.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. Frozen screen, funny noise in the CPU.
Okay, so for you, this is number one. This is number two, number three, and number four, let's say.
Yes.
Okay, thank you, Karina, thank you. Ahora pensemos en su trabajo, en su lugar de trabajo, chicos. In your workplaces. What issues or what problems do you commonly have in your job or in your daily daily activities? What problems or what issues are more common that happens? Y en su trabajo, ¿cuál sería como lo más común que les pasa a ustedes?
No internet access.
Okay.
Papers took in printer.
Oh, okay. Paper stuck in printer. Which one?
Frozen screen.
Yeah. Okay, and what do they usually do to solve those problems? Cuando ustedes llaman a Tech Support por ese problema, ¿qué es lo que usualmente hacen? What is the usual procedure? ¿Cuál es el procedimiento usual?
Restart.
Restart before call to Tech Support.
Okay. Uh-huh. Vale, digamos, ustedes llamaron a Tech Support, okay? ¿Qué es lo que Tech Support hace usualmente? What does Tech Support does usually? What does Tech Support do usually? ¿Qué es lo que normalmente hace?
Ah,
ask question, right? Asking questions.
Asking questions.
Okay. That's the first thing. They start saying as this guy is saying, right? It will be Peter, right? Peter from Tech Support is saying, I see, let me ask you some questions. Let me ask you some questions. ¿Verdad? Empiezan a preguntarle, ¿qué modelo es? ¿Y qué marca es? ¿Y, okay? And they start with questions. So now we think that the most common is not internet access, right? And then we could say deleted files. Deleted files could be the second. Don't you think so? The paper stuck in printer. Yeah, it's very common. Frozen screen. Frozen screen is very common too. Okay, then let's continue and let's see, because we need to learn how to report this, okay? Let's see. Okay, miremos las frases que podemos utilizar para reportar el problema. Let's see the phrases. I would like to report a problem. I would like to report a problem. Next one. I would like to report an issue. I would like to report an issue. I have trouble with. I have trouble with. Y decimos el problema, ¿verdad? O con la computadora, con la aplicación de, del móvil, con la impresora. So we could say the mobile app, the printer, the photocopier, the fax machine, if you still use a fax. Maybe with the headset, with the microphone. Or maybe with the application of the to have video calls. So whatever it is the problem, you say, I have trouble with. Okay, everybody, please activate your audio. And let's say this ways to report a problem. I would like to report a problem.
I would like to report a
problem.
Ahora lo vamos a decir contractado. I'd like to report a problem. I would like to report an issue.
I would like to report
an issue.
I'd like to report an issue.
I'd like to
report an issue.
I have trouble with. Okay, y ustedes recuerdan una frase bien común. Houston, Houston, we have a problem. Houston, Houston, we have a problem. Do you remember that? Uh-huh. That's a very good way to say it, okay? Okay, okay. Sorry. Okay, oh my God, this is funny. I don't have any toy here. Okay, there you are. Sí que me agarró de sorpresa. Okay, do you remember that when they say, Houston, Houston, we have a problem. Houston, Houston, we have a problem. Ahora es una frase como común y que para todo, ¿verdad? Cuando vamos a decir, hey, Houston, Houston, tenemos un problema. Pero en realidad es una buena manera, ¿ok? Es la manera más común y más fácil de reportar un problema cuando nos compete a todo el departamento de la compañía. Por ejemplo, a todos recursos humanos. Vamos a decir, we have a problem with, ¿ok? We have trouble with. For example, We have trouble with the passwords. Okay. We have trouble with the new passwords. Todos están teniendo el problema al mismo tiempo. Then we say we, because everybody in the department are having the same problem. Okay. And you are calling on behalf of everyone. Okay. On behalf of the group. So we say we have a problem. We have a problem. Okay. Oh, sorry. The common issues to report. The common issues to report. ¿Cuál es la manera de hacerlo? Ah, utilizamos el presente simple. Okay. The present simple. If it is in a negative way, then we use it does not. It doesn't. In the affirmative way, we say it makes, it has, it does, okay? So let's read this one. It does not seem to work. Contractado, it doesn't seem to work. It makes, remember, que lleva una letra S porque es tercera, ¿verdad? Es tercera persona. It makes a strange, funny noise. Or a strange noise or a funny noise, okay? It doesn't turn on. It doesn't turn on. No enciende, okay? It doesn't turn on. Ahora, regresando a lo mismo, debemos hacer una listita de los problemas más comunes que ustedes tienen. Let's see. Write down the most common problems you have with the equipment or the equipment, I'm sorry, in your office, with the problems you and your classmate have in common in the middle section. Okay. La primera cosa que hay que hacer, una lista with your own problems. And the second column, here in the middle, we have to write the problems you and your classmates have in common, okay? For example, aquí sería así. Voy a usar sus nombres en la primera columna. Let's imagine that Ana del Carmen and Ana Cristina are working, okay? And here we have Ana Cristina. Okay. Pero acá en medio van a poner los que las dos tienen en común. Okay. So, una lista aquí, una lista aquí, y aquí las que van en común. ¿Entendido? Oh, we have only seven minutes to finish. Okay, let's do this. No, we'll do it tomorrow, okay? Mañana vamos a hacer esta actividad al entrar para que lo hagan por ustedes mismos, okay? For yourselves.
Teacher, in the leaves, the problems, the computer.
Yes, you have to write the common problems that you have to call tech support. Los problemas que se le presentan para que usted llame a tech support.
Okay.
Los comunes en su trabajo, okay? Okay, entonces lo que voy a hacer ahorita, les voy a enviar un link. Okay. Ok, aquí en el chat lo voy a enviar. It's a video, okay? It's a video. It's about, Maria Elena. It's about Houston, we have a problem, okay? It's about the movie. It's the movie. So you're going to watch, and I want you to see the way they report the problem and the way they solve the problem. It's short. It lasts 10 minutes approximately. So we're gonna watch it right now for los primeros dos minutos del video, okay? So everybody please, watching the video. Astrid, are you there? ¿Todos viendo el video solo los primeros dos minutos? Okay, what do you think? What can you tell me about the video? Questions? What is the way to call tech support? What is the way? Right? Something immediately, right? Because they need this solved immediately. It's life or death, right? It's a matter of life or death. It's a matter, it's an urgent matter, right? It's urgent matter. Es algo sumamente inmediato, ¿verdad? Cuando uno llama para reportar un problema, right? When you call to report a problem, it's because you tried everything to solve it and you could not do anything to have it solved, okay? Ustedes no pudieron hacer nada para resolverlo, entonces necesitan al experto. So this is what we're talking about. This is what we're talking about. Did you like that movie? Do you like that movie? ¿No la han visto?
Not the chair.
It's a very nice movie. It's a very nice movie. Se las recomiendo. I recommend you to watch it. Mm-hmm. Ahí van a aprender bastante vocabulario precisamente de esto. Reportando problemas y viendo cómo solucionan problemas. Okay. They use a lot. I am doing something. I am doing this. I am doing that. Okay. It's kind of exciting. It's an exciting movie. Okay, guys, it's 10 o'clock, so we are going to take the attendance. Alejandra Vanessa Mora Rodríguez.
Present, teacher.
Okay. Ana Cristina Chavarría Flores.
Present, teacher.
Ana del Carmen Mejía Álvarez.
Present.
Oyeron la gran puya.
Ana del Carmen Mejía Álvarez.
Present.
Astrid Tatiana. Present. Okay, Ana del Carmen. Astrid Tatiana Jiménez Ramírez.
Present, teacher.
Okay. Vladimir Antonio Santos Valdivieso.
Present.
Carlos Eduardo Maldonado present. Vázquez. Okay. Giovanni Alexander Ramírez Sánchez. Jonathan present. Ernesto Fuentes Marín. Juan Carlos Palacios Ramírez. Karina Noemí Álvarez Mejía.
Present.
Carla Verónica Zuria López. Carla Verónica. Kevin Antonio Ramírez Sánchez.
Present.
María Elena Romero de Galvez. Oh, she sent a message. Omar Alfredo Mozo Flores.
Present.
Ok. Raquel Judith Vázquez de Córdoba.
Present.
Wendy Xiomara Núñez.
Present, teacher.
Ok. Edwin Eliseo Orellana Vivas.
Present.
Aurielena Segovia Rugamas. Félix Moisés Blanco Araniva. Javier Adolfo Mendoza Tobar.
Ficha, no me mencionó.
Nancy. Oh, okay. One second. One second. Es que quiero ver, permíteme. Permítame. But I checked you in. Nancy Ivette Tobar Rivera. Okay. Then you have to say present. Okay. There you are. Okay. El turno para ahora es de Omar. Okay. Omar, are you staying? ¿Se va a quedar?
Yes,
para
sir.
Consulta. Okay. Then have a good night, everyone. And let's see. I see you tomorrow. Tonight, teacher. Yeah, because on Friday I say I see you tomorrow and it was the weekend, so I was like, good night, have a good night, have a good rest. Hello, Omar. How are you tonight? I see you're very tired.
Yes, I've been coming from work. Me perdí bastante la clase, teacher.
Oh, okay.
I'm disappointed.
I can tell, yeah. It's a very big problem not to be in the class. Is there anything that you want me to reinforce or maybe that you want to ask? Questions?
Yes, I have a problem with resolver problemas, lo que estaban hablando de prácticamente todo lo perdí.
Oh, okay. Then let's start. Vamos a hacer un pequeño resumen, a little summary, okay? Short summary.
Okay.
Let's see. So it's briefing, okay? It's a very brief summary. Let me share in the screen. Everything you have it in your manual, okay? Let me see if the manual is here. One second. Okay. Here it is. It says, it's page 39. Okay, page 39. So we were saying that there is a way, or there are specific ways to contact tech support to have a problem solved or a problem solution, okay? Y hacíamos la pregunta, do you ever call tech support? ¿Que si alguna vez usted llama a soporte técnico? Okay, do you ever call tech support?
Okay. Tech support, technical support.
We are talking about problems with your computer or maybe with your with any application or the system, the company system, maybe accounting system or any system that you have to use to do your job. Or maybe, for example, with a printer or the appliances or the devices, like if they provide you with a mobile phone, if you are having a problem with that device, then you report it, right? What is the way to report a problem? This is what we are learning, okay? We are learning how to report a problem. How to report a problem. So in this case, we were learning this in a conversation because this is a very basic conversation, but it is the most common that we can have, but es como la más acertada o la más práctica, okay? So we call tech support, for example, the extension, right? The extension, and then we call and someone from tech support answer, okay? Someone from tech support answers and y se presenta, ¿verdad? Dice su nombre, okay? Y ofrece su ayuda. ¿Cuál es la manera de hacerlo? Esta que está en la conversación.
Okay, teacher, I can use, I like, me gustaría...
Oh,
I like to report a problem, reportar el problema, ¿verdad?
Yes. Lo vamos a escribir aquí. Eso proviene de I would like to. La frase completa es would like to. Ok, la frase completa. Esto va junto siempre. Would like to. Si usted mira esto, quiere decir, o esto significa como que usted esté diciendo I want. Ok, pero de una forma cortés. O sea, una forma con mucha cortesía, con mucha amabilidad. No está imponiendo la cosa, ¿verdad? Como decir, si usted dice, hey, mira, yo quiero que, entonces ya dijo directo, ¿verdad? Pero si usted dice, I would like to, es como un poquito más polite. It's more polite.
Como me gustaría, pero no es algo.
Yes, correct. Mm-hmm. Okay. That's the idea, correct.
Okay.
Pero como queremos sonar más fluidos, ¿verdad? Entonces venimos y utilizamos la contracción. The contraction is I'd like to. Okay? I'd. Okay. I'd. I'd. Mm-hmm. It's a letter D. Y no cambia para ninguna de las personas. Okay? This will be, for example, you would like to. Okay?
Okay.
Y siempre la contracción sería la letra D. Okay? You'd like to.
Okay, mm-hmm. I have a problem with the preposition.
Oh, okay, but in this case, we always are going to use to. Okay. En esta siempre vamos a utilizar would like to, would like to. Va junto.
Okay.
Ahí no cambia. Okay. Donde estamos cambiando ahorita son los pronombres. Para ver que como cuando decimos he, she or it, cambian los verbos, ¿verdad? Cambian las conjugaciones. Okay. En este caso, no. En este caso, they don't change. For example, we say he would like to. Y la contracción is the same. He'd like to. Okay?
Okay.
She is the same thing. Okay? And so on. If we say we, for example, we say would like to. Igual, the same in the contraction, okay? We'd like to. Okay?
Okay.
It's the same for they. They don't change, so it will be they don't. I'm sorry. Would like to. Okay. And then they'd like to. Okay. The contraction. Okay. Estoy así como que se me cruzó todo. Okay. They would like to. Ellos quieren. Eso imagínense que a usted le toca hacer la llamada. Y usted va a reportar el problema, pero no es su problema, sino que el problema de ellos, de sus colegas, ¿verdad? O de sus subalternos también podría ser, ¿verdad? Entonces usted puede decir, they'd like to, ¿ok? Correcto.
Ok, they like to
report a problem.
Report problem, okay.
Yeah, report a problem.
Ok.
Esta es una frase muy práctica que puede usar siempre para cuando va a reportar un problema. I'd like to report a problem. O si es que usted, then you would like to report a problem, etc. ¿Ok? Esa es la manera de reportar el problema. Luego tenemos frases. Más abajito teníamos unas frases. Bueno, estos son problemas comunes. ¿Ok? Common problems, common issues. Issue es lo mismo, bueno, es parecido a trouble y a problem. Entonces, cuando hablamos con tech support, hay issues, hay problems y hay trouble. Okay? Issues, problem and trouble. Son tres palabras para referirnos a que hay un problema. ¿Verdad?
Okay. Okay.
Let me erase this. Entonces, por ejemplo, si yo digo, I'd like to report a problem. I have no internet access. Okay, I have no internet access, for example. Or I don't have internet access. ¿Verdad? Que sería el presente simple, como estábamos diciendo, que para reportar un problema, tiene que usar el presente simple, así.
Okay, okay, would like to. Okay.
Ajá. And okay. Now let's see. I would like to report a problem. And then we say, it makes a strange noise. Está haciendo un ruido raro, ¿verdad? It makes a strange noise. Or a funny noise.
Funny noise es como raro.
Raro.
Funny es como... funny es como divertido si va el solo, ¿verdad?
Oh, sí, sí, in a different sense. Ajá. Pero en este caso es como raro, como extraño. Okay. There you are. Okay, then this is what we were studying. I would like to report an issue. Era lo que le decía, que tenemos otras palabras para definir problema, issue, situación, okay, que sería issue, ¿verdad? O problem, like that, problem. Es algo que necesita una solución que yo no puedo dar. For example, a problem. An issue puede ser algo así como que sí, es una situación, busquémosle la solución, ¿ok? Pero no es aquella cosa que es imposible en el momento, right? No, issue es una situación.
Ok, dicho.
Y tenemos la otra palabra, I have trouble. Trouble. Si se fija, sí, decimos a problem, an issue, pero trouble no decimos a trouble. Decimos I have trouble. Sin,
oh, okay,
sin any an, okay? I have trouble.
In trouble, is trouble, se escucha como, como diferente, como, how I can difference.
The two words. Travel. Okay, travel and trouble. La otra es como la V, ¿verdad? Travel, vel. Y la otra, okay, es trouble, bull.
Okay.
Uh-huh. Pero ya en lo rápido quizás puede llegar a confundirle, pero en realidad puede diferenciarlo de acuerdo al contexto, ¿verdad? Uh-huh. De acuerdo al contexto, usted va a diferenciar que le están hablando del problema. Digo yo, pues sería como una de las maneras. Pero de ahí la pronunciación, bull, y la otra, the. Okay.
Trouble.
Correct.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. Okay, then that's it. Mañana vamos a estar haciendo la actividad, así que de una vez vaya pensándola, de pensar en los problemas comunes que usted tiene o podría tener, por ejemplo, con su, en su diario, en su trabajo diario, ¿verdad? Otro compañero va a estar llenando esta otra columna y entre los dos, aquí en medio de esta columna, van a poner los problemas comunes entre los dos, digamos lo que le pasa a los dos comúnmente.
Ok.
Ok. ¿Recibió el link para el video?
Creo en WhatsApp, ¿verdad?
No me recuerdo si lo envié en WhatsApp, lo envié aquí en el Zoom. Déjame ver. Let me see. Oh, yes, I did. Sí. Uh-huh. Sí, ahí está. Entonces,
I need more practice, teacher.
Okay, yeah. ¿Y no pudo practicar la conversación?
Sí, con Giovanni, creo, Giovanni.
Oh, okay.
Más o menos ahí.
Okay, eso es lo básico para poder reportar algo por teléfono, ¿verdad?
Uh-huh. Okay, teacher.
Do you have any other question or is it okay?
Oh, teacher, I dos palabras que tengo una duda. Por ejemplo, okay, en touch es tocar, ¿verdad? Touch.
Yes.
Y knock, por ejemplo, knocking, tocando, o sea,
ajá, Es golpear, como golpear. This is touch is like this. Touch. Let me show you something. For example, touch, touch, knock.
And knock. Ah, okay.
Ajá. Touch, sentir el objeto, ¿verdad? Es touch. I'm touching. Okay. Pero por ejemplo, a la puerta, usted knock. Knock at the door. Ajá. Knock at the door. Or touch. Touch. Touch es tocar.
Uh-huh. Okay,
uno es tocar y otro es llamar a la puerta o golpear a la puerta.
Uh-huh. Okay.
También dicen knockout, ¿verdad? Knockout.
Okay.
¡Pah! Okay. That's knockout. Uh-huh. So it means golpear, pero it has different meanings, but it's the more common. Okay. Es para lo que más se usa. Okay.
Okay, teacher.
Uh-huh. Okay, then. Are we okay already?
Yes. Yes, teacher.
Okay, yes, then. Teacher. Let's meet us tomorrow. Okay?
Okay, teacher. Thank you, teacher.
Okay. Have a good night.
Good night, teacher. Yeah. Take care.
Take care, you too. Thanks.
Thank you.